This is the Medico-Legal Quiz. We have excellent audience prizes, a legal pad, and a doctor pen. So that's for each audience prize or part thereof. This is the preliminary. You may be glad I'm not asking this as a question. Okay, so now about the answer sheet, please write in capital letters, also known as print. Please write in capital letters because are yehi moka medical legal quiz gali's handwriting mein likhenge koi to bhi. We don't have anyone like a pharmacist who can read your writing. So please write like that, and please, the answers are pretty short. So don't write essays and don't take refuge in poor handwriting. Okay, so here we go. There's an image coming up, and there are in fact two images. So there are two books. Both books have titles that mean roughly the same. On the left, as you'll see, is a book by Siddharth Mukherjee on the uncertainty, imprecision, and incompleteness in his field. On the right is Al-Qanun Fil Tibb by Ibn Sina, which is considered the most famous medical textbook ever written, considered by no less a personality than William Osler. This five-volume encyclopedic work was the standard text taught at European universities until the 18th century. You'll see both books. You can name either. They mean more or less the same. Yes. So both the answers are given by Mohammed there. The laws or the canon of medicine. Okay. The next question. Blanks. One assured him kingship. Another, victory in war. The third assured him that he would get the most beautiful woman for a wife. Thus was swayed the dash, dash, dash. Yes, it is the judgment of Paris. Okay. Okay, there are two jokes here. But the answers to both are the same. So the jokes are, President Bush was visiting New Orleans in the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina. He was asked a question about a topic of national importance, not related to the disaster. He replied, I don't care how they get out of the water, as long as they get out alive, because he was focused on the Hurricane Katrina. Another joke about the same person, Bush. George W. Bush thinks X was the decision Washington had to make before crossing the Delaware. So what was the question that he was asked? Or what was the misinterpretation that he made? Or what was X? They're all the same thing or sort of the same thing. Yes, so it is Rho. Okay. There is a title for physicians which was very much in use in the past in India. It used to be a popular title in Eastern India. And it indicates that the holder of the title is the physician of the royals. Now you may have many titles that you can come up with for physicians in the history of India. The way to disambiguate is this clue. It is not a reference to a flair for verse. So you might come up with a title which suggests that the holder of the title has some flair for verse, but it's not that. So find that title and modify it just a bit, so that it fits as a title of the physician for the royals. And Eastern India is a clue. Yes, it's Kabiraj. Yes. Shall I move to the next? XY is the oldest form of advance directive. I'm told that for some people, just that one sentence will do to get to the answer. So go to the answer. Otherwise, it was first proposed at the Euthanasia Society of America in 1967. It drew from existing estate law, by which an individual can control property affairs after death. That's where the why comes from. How do you control property affairs after death? That'll give you why. And devised a way for an individual to express healthcare desires in a situation in which direct communication by the individual is not possible. Hence the name XY. It is a living will. Shall I proceed? Okay, this is a painting of the four evangelists, Luke, John, Mark, and Matthew. That's fine. This is Luke, who's wearing the blue outfit. before he became an evangelist, they all had some prior occupations and in his previous life, not previous life, but you know, in his life, he was a physician. So in this painting, each of those people has been presented with an emblem or some kind of symbol of his or her profession or activity. And this bottle that you see at the feet of Luke is related to the fact that he was a physician. This is a medieval painting, so medieval physicians used to use a bottle for something. What did they use the bottle for? It is urine. And just look at it. I'm moving. Lawrence Fishburne and Chadwick Boseman. You might already think of something, the obvious thing that's in common between those two. Played this person in two movies. In movies whose titles are his first name and last name respectively. Yes, it is Thurgood Marshall. Marshall also is enough, but Thurgood is not enough. Shall I proceed? Four blanks. Building a Safer Health System is a landmark report issued in November 1999 by the US Institute of Medicine. The report brought the issues of medical something and patient safety to the forefront of national concern. And it concluded that 44 to 98,000 people die each year as a result of preventable medical mistakes. What was the appropriate title of this report, acknowledging how common and universal mistakes are? To err is human. In September 2023, the Election Commission launched a special comic book to encourage young eligible voters to register and participate. The comic book titled Dash Dash or Chunavi Dangal was released by Chief Election Commissioner Rajiv Kumar and Election Commissioners Anup Chandra Pandey and Arun Goel. We need to fill that blank with the name of a beloved comic book character. Somebody, somebody, or Chunavi Dangal. Yes. Chacha Chaudhary. This is a tool. Tool in the sense, not a, like a physical implement, but an instrument, a method. Researchers and public health agencies worldwide use a tool called phylogenetic assignment of named global outbreak lineages to track the transmission and spread of SARS-CoV-2, including variants of concern. What short name is this tool better known by? And it is thought to be an apt name considering the disease's transmission. Two of these short versions are acceptable. You can have a short version or a shorter version. Okay, so two things are allowed here. Pango or pangolin. Okay, something was being prohibited. In 2014, China's State Administration for Press, Publication, Radio, Film and Television issued an order to radio and television authorities to cut down on something that they took much joy in. The rationale for this prohibition was to prevent cultural erosion and to prevent misleading the public, particularly children who might latch on to these altered versions instead. Commentators argued that this order might have larger implications, such as preventing punchlines in political cartoons, which typically rely on the activity that was being curbed. Wordplay or puns? Okay. There are two answers here. Ardem Pataputian won the 2021 Nobel Prize for his work on touch receptors. And he named those receptors after the Greek word for pressure. We know this word from fields other than the medical field too. So just look for the Greek word for pressure or whatever word for pressure you have and try to fit it into Greek. So what is that name? Then his team discovered an agonist to this receptor and wanted to give it a certain name. But another molecule called OB1 existed. So they changed the name to X. I'll just let you know right now that X and Y both are something one and something one. Okay, so catching on to the trend, another agonist discovered was named Y. And these names, X and Y, were so chosen as the channels are mechanosensitive. That is, they are force sensors. So give either X or Y. So we need the name for the touch receptors. That is, we need the Greek word for pressure. And we need either X or Y. You can put X and Y. And if one is correct, it's fine. Piezo is right. Jedi is okay. Any idea about X? अरे लुक बोला, डात बोला, मेन का नाम नहीं बोला. हाँ, योडा. आई एम प्रोसीडिंग. अंडर न्यूजीलैंड्स बर्थ्स डेथ्स एंड मैरिजेस रजिस्ट्रेशन एक्ट ऑफ 1995, नेम्स विद द फॉलोइंग फीचर्स आर प्रोहिबिटेड. Names that might cause offense to a reasonable person, not defined. Names that are unreasonably long, not defined. And names that include or resemble an official title or rank. So these are all the kinds of criteria on which names are prohibited, rejected. The most common rejected name was X. We know X as a cardinal virtue, which is why people want to name their children X. But it also doubles up as a title. So what's that name? Yeah, justice is right. What were you thinking? Honor. Most people who see this are shocked that I'm putting out something with so many spelling errors. This is an urban legend that utilizes the transposed letter effect. There's a term that you have to give us. What is the term that has been used to refer to it on the internet? That term combines a condition that diabetics may face with a kind of error. Yes, it is typoglycemia, from typological and hypoglycemia. Okay, I'm moving from this. Your answer is a seven-letter word. That word may first have been recorded, not that word, but that action may first have been recorded in the 8th century BC during the Greek Olympics. It later spread to the armed forces and then to its current avatar, more common. The Oxford English Dictionary traces this seven-letter word in this form to 1850 in the writings of some Charles Holzapfel, a mechanical engineer and technical writer. So that's the important part. A mechanical engineer and technical writer wrote this in 1850, and he was referring to corrugations affording a grip on a piece being roughed. This activity is called bizutage in France and praxe in Portugal. By what name is it known in the Indian subcontinent? There is a toll-free, national toll-free helpline for this in India, which is 1-800-180-5522. And there are many state laws that deal with it. So what do we know it as in the Indian subcontinent? Common word, ragging. It is ragging. Okay. Now, I have here two videos. I am telling you right now that these videos are poor quality, for which I take all credit. I stood outside, I mean, like, I was holding a phone and standing outside, not outside, facing my computer. But anyway, in this first video, you will see Shraddha Kapoor performing an exercise. What is the name of that exercise? In the second video, you will see Shilpa Shetty performing a pranayama. What is the name of that pranayama? Two one-word answers.
आप सुखासन में भी बैठ सकते हैं, आप वज्रासन में भी बैठ सकते हैं. एंड टेक अ डीप ब्रेथ एंड देन रिलीज टू क्रिएट एन ओम वाइब्रेशन. डीप ब्रेथ इन
these were burpee and Brahmari, half points. Now we have question 17. Three of the four are the middle temple, the inner temple, and Gray's Inn. The fourth is the largest and is named not after a US president. So you, going by the name, you might think it's named after a US president. A US president has that name, but that was not named for that US president. It was named for an earl and confidant of King Edward I. The fourth, which is your answer, links Adnan Sami, Iqbal, Bhutto, Jinnah, Gladstone, Shankar Dayal Sharma, Asaduddin Owaisi, Thatcher and Blair. So nice wide range of people. Yes, I heard the name. Lincoln's Inn. Okay, somebody wave at me so that I can go to the next. What cosmetic trend with an alliterative name, #... has become the newest craze sweeping social media? It typically involves paralyzing the trapezius with an injection to flatten the shoulders and create the illusion of a longer neck. Paralyzing the masseter and platysma with the same injection results in a slimmer, heart-shaped lower face and snatched jawline image before and after. So this lady underwent those injections and then looked like this. Barbie Botox is right. Okay, I shall proceed. Since 2000, this has happened 8 times in India. What? Here you see that there is a table. Nationality, age, sex, date, place. I hope it's visible to everyone, all quite clear. Last column, place of dash. Alipur Central Jail, West Bengal. Yerawada Central Jail, Maharashtra. Tihar Central Jail, Delhi. Nagpur Central Jail, Maharashtra. Tihar Central Jail, Delhi. Execution, hanging, capital punishment, not suicide. Okay, I am now. Which class of molecules? These were some of the terms considered for it. Amboceptor, vision corpus, substance, sensibilisatris, copula, desmon, phyllocytase, fixator. Eventually, Paul Ehrlich's choice prevailed. So you may be tempted towards an answer, but please try to make it Paul Ehrlich's choice. Give the word for it that Paul Ehrlich proposed. The human body can make up to a quintillion unique variants of these. It's a huge number. The memorial at Milstein building in Granta Park, Cambridge depicts it. So here's how the molecule looks. Antibodies, shall I proceed? Dowry prohibition, May 6th and 9th, 1961. Banking Service Commission repeal, May 16th, 1978. Prevention of terrorism, May 26th, 2002. These are the only three instances of what, and who is the only person to have been present in all three instances? Okay, that's right. Joint sessions of parliament. Okay, there is a tattoo on the chest of a person. What does this tattoo request or instruct? Please write the answer in English. The answer is, do not resuscitate, do not reanimate, do not revive, do not resurrect. Do not give CPR, do not bring back alive. Shall I proceed? Audio. Repeated, I mean, there are three repetitions. Ek bar sunke likh lena, nahi to do aur bar sun lo. So two questions here. What is this chant called? Try to give the full name of that chant. And who is it addressed to? Please give the commonest name of the person it is addressed to. That person has many names.
Trayambhakai Najamahe Sugandhem Pushti Vadhanam Urvarukami Vabandhanam Rajyon Mukshe Yamamrathade Trayambhakai Najamahe Sugandhem Pushti Vadhanam
It is addressed to someone. That addressee has many, many names. So don't give some complicated idhar udhar ka naam. So it is called Mahamrityunjaya Mantra. I just want Mrityunjaya at least to be there. Last year, 2022, Senior Advocate Gopal Shankaranarayanan asked the Supreme Court to direct the Union Government to recognize ... as a fundamental right. His report, From Stasis to Movement, Actualizing a Fundamental Right to ... in India, suggested that all school boards dedicate at least 90 minutes of every school day to free play and games. He also asked the court to direct the Government of India to establish a national ... mission. And there is the clue, NPLM. Physical literacy. Okay, I've gone to the next year. Justice Kailashnath Vanchu, born 1903, was the first judge in his family. He passed the Indian Civil Service exam in 1924 and underwent 2 years' training in the UK. He returned in 1926 and was stationed as an assistant collector in the United Provinces. He was the Chief Justice of India from April 1967 to February 1968, in which time he authored 355 judgments and primarily adjudicated upon cases relating to labor, property and constitutional law. He has a record as Chief Justice of India. So the record is like this. He is the only Chief Justice of India. You fill in the blank. CGI. Okay, proceeding to 26. There will be a picture coming up. The question is, okay. UMAP, Uniform Manifold Approximation and Projection, is a data visualization technique. One of its many uses is in single cell RNA sequencing to identify specific cell populations and genes expressed by each cell. These plots color code individual cellular populations and cluster them together. So you need to look at this image, see what that image reminds you of, and that is the person after whom these plots are named. So who is that person? Sura is correct. Now you are looking at a brain MRI. The sign which is in the red oval, so that's where you need to focus your attention. This sign is seen in certain neurodegenerative diseases. It shares its name with something that a Christian monk in the Middle Ages developed a recipe for and distributed to the poor on Good Friday. Yes, hot cross buns. Okay, shall I move to... These are the elements of traditional Chinese medicine. If you can actually read Chinese, enjoy. If not, they are the panchabhutas of traditional Chinese medicine. Fire, earth and water, I already put there. But there are two other elements. They are wood and metal. Okay, now we have come to the two-pointer. So there are actually two questions here, right? 29 in the space meant for 29, 30 in 30. But they're related to the same matter, so they're on the same slide. You see many women here. What connects them with respect to India's history? That's 29. In 30, what you will see is that of all these women, we've picked five and put numbers on them. So one of these women, was the Indian delegate on the UN Human Rights Commission in 1947-48. And that woman was responsible for the rephrasing. This was what was going into that declaration at first. All men are born free and equal. And she insisted on changing the phrasing to all human beings are born free and equal. Hansa Mehta is right. Four is right. Okay, we are getting close. We are getting close. It's 40. Okay, so on May 17, 1954, that is 31, delivered the unanimous ruling in the landmark civil rights case X versus Y of Topeka, Kansas. And what he said, his ruling, was that state-sanctioned segregation of public schools was a violation of the 14th Amendment and was therefore unconstitutional. If we don't know him for this, we know him for something else. That President Johnson commissioned less than a decade later. We just want Warren. And X was Brown and Y was Board of Education. I think I can proceed. Okay, this whole thing is to do with secrecy and confidentiality. The first is a phrase. Aphrodite gave a flower to her son Eros, who then gave it to Harpocrates, the god of silence and secrets, to ensure that Aphrodite's dalliances remained hidden. The association with secrets led to this phrase. So we want a phrase. That phrase has a flower in it, and that's the flower that Aphrodite gave her son. So that phrase denotes secrecy. Next question. A rule was first made in 1927 and revised later in XY. XY is the London headquarters of the Royal Institute of International Affairs. And then it was named after that place, that XY. And the rule is, when a meeting or part thereof is held under the XY rule, participants are free to use the information received. But neither the identity nor the affiliation of the speakers, nor that of any other participant may be revealed. So there's confidentiality. Sub rosa, so whatever is under the rose is secret. And Chatham House is the place, so you can follow those rules anywhere. Okay, location and parent-child duo. So we need, a 210 centimeter black bronze sculpture by artist Chintamani Kar was installed at its present location, which is what you have to tell us. On February 20th, 1978, 64 lawyers submitted a memorandum to the then Union Law Minister Shanti Bhushan arguing, the statue is supposedly a symbol and inspiration for the highest institution of justice. The child is nondescript, but the mother's resemblance to X is discernible even to the ordinary eye not trained for appreciating the nuances of sculpture. The symbolism is perverse and the theme stinks of the parent and child cult built up during the Y. So don't bother about giving us Y and all, that's all for your information. Later, the lawyers, after becoming more informed, submitted another memorandum, basically with their tails between their legs, conceding that as the design of the sculpture was finalized in 1969, the design was not made to give a sense of the parent-child duo. Supreme Court is good enough. Okay, Indira Gandhi is okay. Who's the son? Yeah, Sanjay Gandhi is the son. We cannot have the wrong son. Next. Okay, please don't jump away. Let me tell you. Lord Rama had very, very long arms. This gave him a name or a descriptor, X. That descriptor is, you can call it an adjective or a noun. In 2021, Wilfried Zaha became the first Premier League player to refuse to Y. Y is a verb, an action. In the league's pre-match demonstration, both X and Y have a common root for a body part. Ajana Bahu or Ajanu Bhuja. Genuflect or genuflection. Okay, I am now going to the last two questions. X is a Nobel Peace Prize winning entity formed in the backdrop of the Biafra famine during the Nigerian Civil War in 1971. It used the prize money that it received sometime later to start the Access campaign for effective and affordable drugs, tests and vaccines. So X is an entity that is focused on healthcare. Y is an international NGO founded in 1992 in Brussels. It gained prominence in the aftermath of the Rwandan genocide of 1994. And it working towards its stated goal of ensuring legal security, fair justice systems, and human rights for all. They are Médecins Sans Frontières or Avocats Sans Frontières or Doctors Without Borders and Lawyers Without Borders. Hey, please hand over papers. Okay. Because if you don't hand over papers, you'll have to stick to them forever. Here is what. Now please enjoy these two cartoons as I have enjoyed them. This is how the quiz will run. As I already told you, the prelims was a long round. This is short. So make the most of it. How we will proceed is like this. We'll have a clockwise round of 12 questions. Then something special, 5 questions. Then an anti-clockwise round of 12 questions. All of you may please bite your nails in anticipation. So now we'll begin with the clockwise. Pounce is there. Plus 10, minus 5. In some situations, owing to my extreme kindness and reasonableness, I may give no points, you know, rather than giving negatives. For right also I may give no points owing to my extreme reasonableness. Team 1, the first question comes to you. There will be images shown, but Vincent Esch designed X and Y, both in Indo-Saracenic style, facing each other across the river. They cost about 20 lakh rupees each, and this is long ago, so very expensive buildings. X was designed in 1916 in local pink granite and traditional Mughal materials like red sandstone and white marble. X underwent two major name changes in 1956 and in 2014. Y was designed as a three-storied building with 17 domes. A 16-acre park was laid out in front on the riverbank to provide a bright outlook to inmates. A popular sweet salty snack was born in its canteen to serve something nutritious to inmates. This is X. This is Y. This is a painting of Y. It was auctioned off a few years ago at Christie's. So please recognize these two buildings. Various clues, bright outlook to inmates, one clue. Underwent name change in 2014, clue. Please check the pounces. Harshita, here, this team 2 is pounces. So I think the pounce may be considered closed. Is it not? Have you finished? Team 1. Team 1. Okay, not so. 2 has pounced, I believe. Okay, 3. That, whereas you have given the right answer, you will get. Okay, so it's Telangana High Court, it's not High Court of Hyderabad as such, but that was a name change in 2014 to Telangana and Osmania General Hospital. So those were the two buildings. Team 2 gets minus 5, team 3 and 4 get plus 10 each. And this was local and a very good move by team 1 to say Gandhi, but. Team 4 will now answer this question. It has actually 3 parts. Which organization, what purpose, what first? This, which you'll see on the next slide, is a monarch photolithograph made by UK's Crabtree that was really sadly sold as scrap a few years ago. These machines were not available anywhere in India except at this 1767 born government organization. Which? 1767 born government organization. What foundational purpose was it used for in the mid-20th century? And by virtue of having this machine, what other firsts did this organization execute from a century earlier? So 1852 to 1862, this organization executed something first because it had this machine. So let's see the machine, and that's the logo. That's the logo of the organization. Which organization is it? This is the machine that was sold as scrap. Okay, now we are opening for pounds. Opening kya? Close ho gaya. Team 4 will give answers.
NGRI for organization. What was the second? What was the second? Foundational purpose. So they used. It was used during partition because they make maps and you know. So the boundaries were demarcated or were shown using these things. And the other. Trigonometric survey of India is the third part.
We'll say the third part is mapping the height of the Everest. The second part is demarcating the boundaries between India and Pakistan. And the third part, what first did it do? It charted the height of the Everest.
Okay, so the second part, this was used for basically dredging land to reunite the islands of Bombay into one, this thing. Mid-20th century foundational purpose was land reclamation along Bandra Worli. And this is the geographical survey of Society of India.
So the organization is India Post, okay, Department of Posts. The foundational purpose in mid-20s, like they were printed the ballot papers for the first general elections. 52 and 1852, 1862 is where basically Queen Victoria became the Queen of India. So they started putting her silhouette on the India stamps.
The
the map of India, the first constitution copies, all bunch of these things were printed with them. And the third one is the trigonometrical survey of India, where they mapped India.
Survey of India, they only printed the Constitution of India and there's nothing else. And third part will say is they executed the first census that was carried out in India.
First survey.
Have you finished your guess? No. Okay, you also please make your guess.
Okay, Survey of India, Constitution, and they made the first currency.
So the answers have come in various ways from various places. Let us now go to the answers so that I don't have to struggle. And okay, audience, boliye jara. Okay, then. So it's the Survey of India. Team 8 gets 3 points. Team 1 gets 3 points. Team 2 gets 6 points. Team 5 gets 10 points. So team 3 will now get the next question, which is this. If you want, you can pay a lot of attention to that CT of the chest, but otherwise you don't have to. Because the question is not really about what the chest CT shows. The question is, it's a chronic infection in middle lung lobes, and the pathogen is Mycobacterium avium. And it's odd that this disease was seen in otherwise healthy older females. Physicians who theorized that this unusual infection had to do with certain Victorian era manners named it XY syndrome, after a character in a 1905 Oscar Wilde play. So, two questions. What is XY syndrome? How did Victorian manners cause this disease? Acha. Are, Rama, are you raising your hand or just airing your armpits? Okay. you have pounced. You have checked their pounce. Okay. Anyone pouncing? Anyone else pouncing? Our pounce is now closed and we are at Team 3.
Okay. XY will say is Lady Windermere. And, you know, like to hide scars and stuff, they'd put patches of powders on their faces. And automatically, that time, they inhale a few of those particles, and which goes and gets stuck in their lungs.
Which caused the infection.
you are pounced. You. Team 6.
Okay, so the second part, we'll still say that it's the fan. But instead of Lady Windermere, we'll go with Gwendolyn from Importance of Being Earnest.
XY, hai na?
Gwendolyn.
It's the feather bird feather thing.
And it's Lady Bracknell from the Importance of
Being Earnest. I don't even remember this lady. Huh?
Lady Salome. And is the Lady Salome syndrome, and basically the women, the noble women used to wear veils, and veils were made from animal skin, so the bacteria got inhaled because of that.
I'm trying to be as unreactive as possible so that I don't sway anyone.
Lady Windermere and feeding pigeons.
It's a Lady Windermere, and etiquette dictated women could not cough publicly, so yeah, they had
I pray that the scorers give the points. So you said Lady Windermere. Team 2 gets 10 points. Team 3 gets 5 points. Team 5 gets minus 5. And team 3 gets the next question again. The term X came about in the 1780s through a translation error by him. He coined X and also the modern phrase X law as a translation of jus gentium, which the Romans used to refer to the corpus of rules between themselves and the tribes of Italy and other parts of the Roman Empire. So you please translate somewhat badly jus gentium, which means the corpus of rules between themselves and the tribes of Italy and other parts of the Roman Empire. Second question, he wrote a book, the same he, titled Prison Cooking, a collection of utilitarian recipes with suitable kitchen meals designed to maximize nutritious value without raising costs. Where did he intend these recipes to be used? very specific answer for this wear, not general. We are pouncing. Okay, so I'm going to team three. Team three, please. You have a mic with you now.
Okay, for the second part, we'll say Bastille and Birthright.
So for the second part, we'll say it's the Tower of London.
We'll say it's called A Gentleman's Law, which we don't discuss in day to day, but it's called that. He used it in Australia in
the prison,
Port Arthur prison.
So we'll say common law, the first part, and basically Australia, where they were transporting convicts, so that you know, they could have mess there, which could make cheap food.
No, so we are at one now.
We'll say common law and panopticon at the Tower of London.
Okay, same. And plebeian law and panopticon.
Okay, and it started with you. Wait. Audience, like, chhodo. Score dena hai pehle.
What part do you want?
Who said panopticon? Team one gets 5 points. What is the story of this team? Okay, team five gets -5. And the word is going to, like, you may spit at this word, but don't spit at me. Audience. It's almost like that, almost tall like that. So now you'll see what the answer is. It is international, like how different nations interact from those tribes, etc., etc. And he meant it to be used here, but as it turns out, it was not made. We will move to team two. It's your question now. In the 1920s, Robin Farios, a Swedish physician studying the history of medicine, that's what is bold, that's what he's studying, observed that when blood is left undisturbed in a container, different layers can be seen. Here are the different layers. A dark clot at the bottom, above it a layer of red blood cells, above it a whitish layer of white blood cells, at the top a layer of clear yellow serum. What did he consider this a potential origin of? And you and three and two are pouncing. Okay. Team two.
The four humors, they all associate to specific colors. Yellow, bile, sanguine, and...
So though you have spoken about humors, you have said nothing funny. 10 points to team two. And others, who? 3, 4, 5, 6. 1 and 7. Arey, koi bacha hi nahi, only 8 is left. Okay, so all but 8 get 10 points. So this is what he thought, because you can see the four things. He was not right. Team 3. A two-word title was used for a paper making a reference to a set of 5th century BC philosophical problems. What is that two-word title? The paper argues that animals can be bred specifically for organ donation, and the transplanted organs perform at least as well as human organs, if not better. And 2 heart and 1 kidney transplant from pigs to humans have already been done since 2022. So here, let's look at the paper with certain important things blanked out. Why pig cells are better for tissue transplants than human cells? And a few lines into the paper, there's a word that is not the same as the title, but close. So that's also blanked out. Okay, I think we will move fast, because although this is a short quiz, it's not an like an insubstantial quiz, so we should move. Team 3, please. Nobody is bouncing? Okay, team 3.
Okay, so say the original problems are the Socratic dialogues, so this is the Socratic dialogues, S-O-W.
Oh, nice guess, but...
Problems are Zeno's logos, and because it's a foreign, they probably made it X-E-N or Zeno logos, as in foreign, Zeno logos.
Would you modify that a bit?
Zeno's paradoxes.
Please take the 10 points on grounds of having said Zeno's paradox. Somebody else's question, I cannot play too much with it. But that word there was Zeno transplantation, so couldn't have left it open. Nice, your sow critic is even nicer, but it's not the correct one. But because there are other animals, there are goats and so on. Okay. Only team 4 gets 10 points and nobody else gets anything here, okay? Team 5, two questions. This is from the first page of a landmark 2011 Supreme Court judgment given by a bench headed by Justice Kajju. Later he called the case perhaps the most difficult case Justice Gyan Sudha Mishra and I faced in our judicial careers. I'll just show it to you and come back. So here is it. Some things have been blanked out here. I just want to draw your attention to the quote. Marte hain arzu mein marne ki, maut aati hai par nahi aati. It translates to one dies longing for death, but death, despite being around, is elusive. So who was the petitioner and whose quote was it? Marte hain arzu mein marne ki, maut aati hai par nahi aati. I think all pounces have been checked. Team 5 will now give the answer.
Aruna Shanbag versus Union of India and Mirza Ghalib.
And we'll take 10 points like that, and others will also take 10 points, I think, in all. Oh, okay. Team 8 gets minus 5. And now team 6. What is X? What is Y? That is one part. What is the process or event? That is one part. This society, a particular society, held the belief that X and Y were equal in the eyes of God, but not in the eyes of the devil. X's souls were seen as unprotected in their so-called weak and vulnerable bodies. Who are X and Y? They are equal in the eyes of God, but not in the eyes of the devil. So the devil has good access to X's because they are vulnerable. Question 2 in this. G. Burroughs was one of the few wise targeted. He confounded his detractors by reciting the Lord's Prayer. But that didn't change the process or event that he and some others underwent. What process or event was this? Team 1 is pouncing. And I think that's it. That's one team there that pounced, two teams here, and that's all. Huh? Only one. Okay. Okay. So we are, I forgot again where we are. We are at team 6.
So the first part we'll say is baptized and unbaptized children. And the second part.
We'll say it's lobotomy.
Okay. No. 7.
Okay. We'll say X and Y are circumcised and uncircumcised. And the event they underwent is the Inquisition.
Yeah,
Inquisition. Interrogation.
Okay, completely random. We'll say X and Y are witches and warlocks, and basically burning at the stake during the Inquisition or whatever.
No.
Second part will say Salem witch trials.
Why warlocks?
Please, team 2. थोड़ा एक्स एंड वाई को स्लाइटली मॉडिफाई करो नो नो द रेस्ट ऑफ देयर आंसर इज करेक्ट
या
ओके सो
कॉन्सेप्चुअली
या या यू प्लीज
विचेस एंड
नो नो यू डोंट से
ओके यू सेड सेलम विच ट्रायल्स दैट मींस हूएवर वाज पर्सिक्यूटेड देयर वाज टू बी अ विच ओके नाउ टेल मी व्हाट एक्स एंड वाई आर
Witches and non-witches.
Okay, what I'm going to do is not take you to your doom, but give you 10 points. Because what I was looking for is just women and men, which is okay. So if you had actually said, Salem witch trials, a particular event, because burning can take place anywhere and everywhere. So team 2 will get 10 points. Team 1 gets 10 points. Team 4 and 5 get 10 points each. And that's what happened. Whose question is it? Yours, 3. Article 13 of Switzerland's Animal Protection Ordinance mandates, something. If you want to keep any of these as pets, there's a big list of pets. Guinea pigs, mice, gerbils, rats, degus, chinchillas and ferrets, rabbits younger than 8 weeks of age, goldfish, lovebirds, Japanese quails, parrots, canaries, finches. So you've seen there's a big list of pets. For gold hamsters, however, the opposite holds true. So we want to know what that mandate is. And some more things to help you. In case a pet dies, one must quickly replace it to uphold the mandate. There are also guinea pig rental services that allow you to meet exigencies. And why would you be so concerned? Because violations carry a fine of up to 20,000 Swiss francs and imprisonment up to 180 days. So it's really important that you follow this if you're keeping these pets. What is it that you're trying to follow? People have pounced. Three, you please start.
Okay, they should be vaccinated for plague and stuff.
Okay, no.
We'll just say that whole idea is that you have pets like these, you should just continue giving them the same name so that don't give... So that like a child, if they have it, they don't think it's a new animal.
Like,
or something
King Rama ka jaisa. Rama, 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 Rama.
So essentially we say that there needs to be, there's a mandate of a regular like health status or health checkup of all these pets at any point of time, because they're keeping track of all these pets and they have it on record. So they need to have a very regular check of, you know, their status, whether they're deceased and stuff.
Okay, not so. And team 5 gets 10, team 4 gets 10, 6 gets 10, 7 gets 10, 8 gets 10. 3, which code is this and what change came into that code? So under section 53, the punishments to which offenders are liable under the provisions of this code are kisas, which means retribution, diyat, which means blood money or ransom, arsh, which is pre-specified compensation, daman, which is compensation determined by the court, tazir, which is discretionary punishment, after which we run out of the other language and now only English, death, imprisonment for life, imprisonment, rigorous or simple, not for life, forfeiture of property, or fine. So which code is this? One question. The other is, in 1979, as part of a political movement, what change was made to this code, essentially for crimes that crossed limits? And okay, we have to move fast. It doesn't look like anyone is pouncing. Is anyone pouncing? Okay, no one is pouncing. Team 3, you can begin because I think no one is pouncing. I have in fact closed the pounce, so then you cannot pounce anymore. So team 3.
Okay, we'll say this is some code of the Sharia law which dictates how a fatwa can be processed or like dictated out. And the second part is when the Iranian revolution happened, the Ayatollah sort of assumed supremacy not only over his area of jurisdiction but over the whole world, and he could issue the fatwa outside.
We'll say that the code is hadood, and we are going to say hadood for the second part also. It was renamed to hadood.
You really like it.
So second part, we'll say they added lashes as a punishment, like lashing. Lashing, I'm guessing. So, and then first part is some Iranian code based on Sharia, Iranian criminal code or something like that. Okay.
Six.
We'll say the first part is the Pakistan penal code. And in 1979, Hudud was enacted, so all of that.
Okay, so all of that is the right answer. It is 5 points to team 4 for placing Hudud where they placed it. And 10 points to team 6 for placing both the right answers in the place where they should have been placed. Okay, so team 7 gets the question. Which plant and what side effect? Let's look at the image. The image is two images. You have seen the image, but I'll go back and then I'll come back. Dr. Paul Gachet was Van Gogh's physician, and he used the plant shown in the painting. So you'll see the plant in the painting. To treat his Van Gogh's epilepsy and mania, the active ingredient in this plant has a side effect. And that side effect explains the peculiarity of Van Gogh's later paintings, including the later one on the slide. So which plant, what is the side effect? Okay, so the pounce is now closed and we are at team 7.
So we'll first take the second part. Basically, the side effects were that you would hallucinate and see lights and streaks where they did not exist, and bright lights and streaks where they did not exist, which is why in these paintings as well as in Starry Night, those patterns are there. The first part we'll say is woodworm.
We'll say the plant is belladonna, and it basically dilates eyes, and so everything becomes brighter and more colorful in general.
In two answers, we'll say foxglove, and it made his vision yellow, so we'll like that.
On that basis, you will get 10 points because you combined the right answers. Someone said foxglove. Team 8, 5 points. Team 2, 10. Team 4, 10. Team 5 ko 10 hi aa gaya. others are not. Team 6. Team 6, what is X? In 1905, the US prohibited anyone other than the State Department from providing or presenting X's. Why? Because speculative unofficial X's could cause people to change their behavior, leading to public chaos. Although most would associate X's with the news, this law muzzled farmers and fishermen the most. Given their occupation, X's from farmers and fishermen may have been considered valid, and the State Department did not want to risk its monopoly. 3, 4, and 5 have pounced. 2 and that's it. Team 6.
The weather reports.
Yes, weather reports. So 6 and everyone else who pounced is getting it. Others, please do not give any answers. It's a special round. When the time comes for answers, you'll get it. It's a round called Sensibles. Sensibles is a written round. There are 5 questions. Why? Because there are 5 senses that we are going to test here. First question on sight. The question is simple. What is this object? Okay, menstrual cup, and you have not got a prize till now, or have you? Okay, next, hearing. I'll play something, an object is making that noise. So you say, I cut out your troubles in a big way because it's not an animal or anything, it's an object. So it is an object used in certain healing therapies. What is that object? Description is fine. I will accept about 3 answers or 4 answers. Okay. All those bowl rena, kaise to bhi rena, attached to bowl, singing, meditation, Buddhist, Tibetan, all these are allowed. Okay. Next sense is smell. You have a question and you have something to smell. Only you can. You are all receiving some strips. Smell them. René Maurice of Etablissement Gattefosse in Lyon was almost single-handedly responsible for the great development in the cultivation, recognition, and popularization of X, which you also have with you now. In 1910, while working in his laboratory, he was a chemist, he was badly burnt by a splash of boiling essence from a flask. He was progressing to gangrene on conventional treatment when he remembered reports from X growers. The reports were of burns healing with X oil. He proceeded to coat his skin with X oil. His fever and infection abated and the wounds healed without leaving a trace, so not even scars. What is X, which all of you are now smelling? Yes, it was lavender. You have all received some cups, or you are receiving, and you have 3 spoons, 1 for each of you. So taste it. It's nothing will happen to you except that you will become very healthy. So you will taste this and you will recognize what that preparation is. But what I want is the principal ingredient of that preparation. There are many, many, many ingredients, but one ingredient by weight, volume, etc., action, supersedes everything else. What is that ingredient? To help you, what I want to say is, you know, I expect a name of a root or a fruit or a leaf or a... Amla is right. So amla, gooseberry, nellika, usrika, or any other language which you can confirm for me is okay. And then we have touch. But touch also includes vision. I think many of you will recognize this by vision. If you want, you can taste it. It's very dull tasting. Again, won't harm you. This seed does not have the properties you are worried about. The properties you are worried about, or in fact seeking, are in other parts of the plant, not in the seed. Can you tell us what? Because it's also a food. The seed is a food. My friend from a part of India where the seed is made into a food item gave me these seeds. Because the seeds are a food item. Everything else is not a food item. Bhang is okay, cannabis is okay, hemp is okay, marijuana is okay. Not poppy, you cannot go to another plant. You have to remain in this plant. We are going anti-clockwise now, so we are beginning with 8. Okay, now we are moving to team 8 because we are going in the other way. Who were tried? Over 200 documented instances of a certain practice now absent from modern legal systems are documented from the 9th to the 19th century. The practice is now viewed as unreasonable and a blot on Europe's judicial history. The most common crimes were murder, crop destruction, and interference with important activities. Punishments meted out to these criminals were on par with those meted out to other criminals, including frequent use of the death penalty. Team 3 is pouncing. Okay, the pounce is now closed and we are at team 8.
We'll say these are animals.
Okay, on those grounds you will get points. They are animals. Team 7 gets 10 points and 5 and 6 get 10 points and 3 gets 10. 2 and 1 get 10. Team 6, you have to connect these two things. One is an eating disorder. You can see what that person is eating. The other is a dermatological disorder. You can see the skin and hair. Yeah. Basically, if you give the names of these two disorders, you will find a connection, but tell me what that connection is. Team 2 is pouncing, and so is 3 and 5. And pounce is now closed, and 6 will answer.
We'll say that one on the right is vitiligo, and whatever the mud-eating thing is called also has the same root.
Team 4, your answer.
So we'll go with pica and piebald.
Okay, what's the connection?
Pie refers to that mix of black and white colors.
Okay.
Color, like pied,
pied colors, like piebaldism, you've got patches of black and white. Black and white, the same thing, you have pica also, you have mixed, you end up with a mixture of black and white stuff that you eat because you've connected as a mixture of black and white.
Okay. You pounced, I think. You also pounced. You did not pounce. One.
Pica and piebald. So, pica and pea in the piebald both come from black.
Okay. Eight in pounds? 8 pounds. Eight.
Pica and piebald. And basically the origin is earth.
Okay. No. And seven.
Pica and piebald. And the P is essentially for the chemical element phosphorus. So it is...
No. You started. No? Okay. Audience. No. No. Nice. Nice. चलो अब क्या करेंगे श्रीनागेश को एक बुक एंड पेन देना है यस दैट इज द आंसर यू आर राइट इन आइडेंटिफाइंग द टू बट द कनेक्शन इज मैगपाई पाइका मीन्स मैगपाई एंड पाइबॉल्ड कम्स फ्रॉम द मैगपाइज कलरेशन सो 3 एंड 5 गॉट 10 पॉइंट्स ईच एंड 2 गॉट 10 6 फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स सो द डैश एंड द डैश फ्रॉम अ पेपर बाय पीटरसन इन 1999 found over 800 judicial opinions in American courts citing Shakespeare, covering all 37 of his plays. And here's an example whether B2 or not B2 is indeed the question from some articles in some judgments and so on. So what is the apt title of the paper? You just have to fill in those two blanks. They are indicative. And they are blanks that are talking about Shakespeare and judicial opinions. So please use, they are alliterative. Hamlet was the most cited play. This is the second question. Which was the most cited line or quote making up about 10% of all the references? This line is not from Hamlet. So now put aside Hamlet and go to everything else. And as the paper said, this line is often used when attorneys attempt to force awkward law or facts into beneficial categories. This is what they said. One is pouncing. Two teams have pounced. Okay, team 6.
So the first part is the bard and the bench.
Okay.
And the second part, but first let's kill all the lawyers.
Okay. I'm sure you're scared of your people in this room. 5 is going to guess.
Okay, we'll say bard and a bench and quality of mercy.
Okay. Team 4.
The title we'll say the bar and the bard.
Okay.
And for the second one, quality of mercy.
Okay, and you pounced and you... Pounced, eh? Two didn't pounce, huh? Okay.
Bar and the bard.
Okay, pass pay, we have to move. Huh?
Yeah.
Okay, you won.
I'll say bar and the bard and Brutus is an honorable man.
No, and you are left. 7.
Bar and the bard.
The good that men do is oft interred with their bones, the evil that men do lives on.
Okay, no, and you are. Okay, so we have to give points to, who said the bard and the bench? You. 5 points to 6 for the bard and the bench. And that's it. Now we are at team 5. Who is X, was X, and what are the two contributions that are... what are those two contributions? In The Hound of the Baskervilles, one of Sherlock's clients refers to him, Sherlock, as the second highest expert in Europe after X. So who is X? X was real. X's two pioneering contributions to forensics are depicted in the next slide. using himself, X, as an example. What are these two contributions? Here are the contributions on this slide. Not very visible, not to me either, but I'll tell you what all they are. The blanking out at the top is that person's name. So obviously, we cannot have his name there. And some details of that person, where that person was born and so on. Okay? And on this side, you can see some numbers and all on top. And the big black box there was his contribution. Two is pouncing. Team 5, your guess now.
So the X is the WIDOC. And then the these things are forensics are one is fingerprints, and the second one are like your description, physical descriptions like a mugshot or an identity kit, what you want to see.
Okay, and you pounced and you did not pounce.
We'll say Henry, the guy's name, fingerprinting and mugshot.
Henry is the surname.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mugshot and fingerprints.
Okay. Two has pounced. One also pounced, I think. Then who's left? Huh?
We'll say this is William James Herschel.
Fingerprints and basically indexing of all the body parts and sizes of a person. This was used as a way of identification earlier.
No, audience, audience below. Okay. Okay, I'm going to give an audience prize to for Alphonse Bertillon. You are team 7. Team 7 is going to get 2.5. Okay, minus 5 to 2 and plus 10 to 1. That's where we are. And we are at team 6 again. And we are going to move through very fast because we have no time left. What purpose were these discs used for? You'll see the discs. In fact, see them now and then come back. These discs are called Ujamit or Ujamik in the Inuit language. What purpose were they used for by the government of Canada from the 1940s to the 70s? There's a book by Norma Dunning, recent book. It's called Kinawit Watts something something. The Eskimo disc system and a daughter's search for her grandmother. But you need to look at these discs, and they were used by the government of Canada from the 1940s to the 70s. Something is blanked out, you, obviously. You can see Canada on it. Then you can see E3-4. 1457, Billy E6-935. Team 6 is direct. Anyone pouncing? Government of Canada. If someone else used, it is unbeknownst to me. Team 2 is pouncing and team 1 has pounced. Anyone here pouncing? Okay, team 6.
We'll say that the Inuit people were, they didn't have like traditional names with a first name and a family name and stuff like that. So the government just gave them these identifier tags with a certain serial number and a first name. So based on that, they had to basically trace back their family lineage.
Okay, and that is right. They were used as surnames. So team 6 gets 10 points and minus 5 to 1, minus 5 to 2. Nobody else here pounced. Okay, so team 5 gets the next question. And that book was called What's Your Name? What's the nickname and what's the quirk? Alvar Gullstrand, a Swedish ophthalmologist, declined a Nobel Prize in physics and won a Nobel Prize in medicine. So please note that he's an expert in fields such as physics and medicine. His major contribution to the field is shown in the next slide. I'll show it to you and then I'll show it to you again. Given his invention, what nickname was he given? This nickname makes a reference to a 19th century pioneer in healthcare. Question 2. As chair of the Nobel Committee, he gave an unfavorable review of a certain scientist's work as not useful enough for the human race, noting that the effects of that scientist's work, measurable by physical means, are however so small that in general they lie below the limits of experimental error. And because of this review, there happened a quirk in the history of science. What is that quirk? So for that quirk, I want you to name a scientist and then the quirk. So it looks like team 1 may be pouncing, others are restraining themselves. 5. Okay, team 5.
We are assuming he got like man with a lamp for a lady with a lamp. So he was nicknamed that. And the second part, quirk, is basically because he said Einstein's theory of relativity is not useful enough, he got Nobel for photoelectric.
Okay, 10 points to you for that. He was called gentleman with a lamp. Gentle light le sakte. And this is what happened. Einstein got the Nobel for something instead of for something else. Okay, minus 5 to 1, minus 5 to 2, and minus 5 to 7. Okay. The number is please accept my profuse apologies. Plus 10 to 7. Shall I put it on your screen? Question to you, team 4, and to all of you. Who is one question? What did he come up with is another question. His picture is there. Let's go to his picture, look at it very quickly, then come back. This ICS officer, jurist and diplomat was the person who prepared the draft of the constitution under Ambedkar's drafting committee. He also drafted Burma's constitution in 1947 and was later judge at the International Court of Justice. Who is that person? Who you can see in the next slide again. Among his other contributions whose reverberations are still felt is his role as the chairman of a 1941 committee appointed by the British. It received much publicity and was revived in 1944 to expand on its recommendations. What did he come up with? So, who and what? Pounce is now open. Okay, I think no one is showing inclinations to Pounce. Team 4.
So, for the first part, we'll say Benegal Narsingh Rao. And for the second part, we'll say he... reservations of some sort in affirmative action of some sort was the first recommendation.
Three. Okay. Two.
We'll say Benegal Narsingh Rao. The second part we'll say is that he wanted states to be reorganized on linguistic and other basis, not the older states as they were, right?
Okay, one you pounced, I think. No, you didn't pounce. Nobody pounced, in fact. Okay, one jaldi bolo.
We'll say Rao for the first part, and we'll say he basically decided the drawing up the borders of the newly created state of Israel.
Eight.
Rao and representation in parliament. I mean, the mapping of constituencies and all.
Seven.
We'll say Rao and basically India-Pakistan working recommendations towards Redcliffe.
Cyril Radcliffe
about the partitions.
Okay. Six. We'll say this is B.N. Rao, and the second part we'll say is the concept of upper house and lower house in the parliament was because of his recommendations.
Five.
Having women's seats in legislature as a reserve, you know, earmarked seats for women in legislatures, legislative bodies, B.N. Rao.
And the answer is Hindu court bill. Okay, team three now. Okay, how did they decide? What is there to decide? The UK VAT and Duties Tribunal in 2004 had to decide whether this particular product, McVitie's Jaffa Cakes, which is a popular snack in the UK, are cakes or biscuits. The company wanted them to be categorized as cakes so as to carry zero VAT. Following a detailed analysis, the tribunal was faced with pretty evenly balanced arguments on both sides. So how did they finally resolve the cake? You can see some of those arguments. If you want, you should read them because then you shouldn't give these as the answer. Name, size, manufacturing process is cake-like, packaging is biscuit-like, sponge cake is the base, presentation and marketing is like biscuits. They're soft unlike biscuits, they're directed primarily to children like biscuits. Two pounced, okay. Four pounced, and now we have close pounds, and three will give the answer.
So we'll say basically they took tea or milk and then they like dipped it and then it produced a good biscuit-like effect when they ate it like that. So that is the...
Now one give the answer, please.
They just polled some kids and asked them what it was.
Okay. Seven, you pounced. Six.
So we'll say that cakes perish quicker than biscuits. Biscuits have a longer shelf life. So since these were like going bad before a certain amount of time, they classified them as cakes.
Okay. You didn't...
So basically, they decided by saying how generally people eat it. If they dipped it, it was tea. If they had it without dipping in tea, it was biscuit. So based on that... the other way around.
Okay,
based on
you,
that logic.
You pounced. Okay, nobody is left here. But the audience, Arun. So that was the answer. What have you done with the pounce? 10 points to team 4. Plus 10 to team 7 and minus 5 to team 2. Okay, so Okay, we have three questions and we are going very fast. You have to pounce while the question is finished. Ante. What term? Team 3, we have to leave. Team 3, this term was coined in 2012 for the observation that drug discovery is becoming slower and more expensive over time, despite improvements in technology. You can see it in the graph. It is named because there's another observation which is quite the opposite of this one. That's how you get the term. Okay, anyone pounced? Yeah, what is the term for this? Three, please. That's right. So three gets 10 points and so does four get 10 points. And we are going to two. Who's the painter? What's the significance of the color scheme? You'll see them. The history of cardiology. It has two panels of 6 into 4 meters dimensions completed in time for the inauguration of the National Institute of Cardiology of a particular country. That painter is from that particular country only. Look at the style, identify the painter. And you'll see the color scheme. There is some significance of the color scheme. There is a person who has been pointed out in the panel. Perhaps looking at that person and considering that it's the history of cardiology, you will find out the significance of the color scheme. So who's the painter? What's the significance of this color scheme? There's a person in the first panel who has a dotted red circle around him.
William Harvey, who spoke about the circulation of blood in the human body. Essentially, it's about when the blood is oxygenated versus when the blood is not oxygenated. It is green versus blue and green versus red.
Okay, 10 points to you. It's not green, it's blue. But deoxygenation, all those kinds of things. So 10 points to team 2 and 4 and 3 and 1. This is the penultimate question, but we have no time, so let's move. Nothing will happen to the scores. Enjoy, kill, die. Where are these lines from? In the 2018 Delhi High Court judgment sentencing former Congress MP Sajjan Kumar to life imprisonment in the 1984 anti-Sikh riots case, Justice Muralidhar quoted the following lines. Sprouted poisonous weeds far and near, and where seeds of hatred have grown high. Bloodshed is everywhere. Poison breeze in forests turned bamboo flutes into snakes. Their venom has turned the bright and rosy Punjab all blue. Okay, I think pounce is not allowed. We are at team one. Team one. Pinjar Amrita Pritam. Eight. No time for audience. It is Amrita Pritam, so 5 points to team one. But the work, that's why I was struggling. I thought, if work to bhi bole to kuch hota tha. Now we go to team eight. This is the last question. Two questions. What pioneering discoveries did Anita Harding, who is here, publish in the journal Nature in 1986? That is one question. Many different versions of the answer that get to the answer are acceptable, so don't hesitate. How did Nature honor her in 2019? Nature, the journal, honor her in 2019. Here is Nature. Here is Anita Harding. And here is her discovery. Okay, so I think no one is pouncing or no one can be allowed to pounce. Team 8. Team 8, this is your question. You can start.
We'll say polymerase chain reaction. And they named a column after her in the journal.
So we'll say Human Genome Project for the first part, and the second part, basically Nature replaced the blank logo with the logo genome of the genome, whatever that is in the that's image.
That
they've basically...
That there is genetic material not only in the nucleus but in the mitochondria as well. So heteroplasmy, etc., etc. And the font is named Harding.
Oh, very nice.
Now, so in a... You know, not the column alone, not the cover alone. She is on the cover, but in the font. Okay, so thank you all very much. Audience, no time. Manu ki baat. Manu ki baat, what? Slipping up and down and finally you won. Okay, and second is Peter Panchali. And so congrats to all eight of you, in fact, but particularly to... Okay, so thank you all very much.